Indeed. 18 minutes on the other side of the 11 o'clock. It is Choice Radio, your life, your salvation, your choice. And we thank you for listening. If you're a first-time listener, welcome to Choice Radio, your life, your salvation, your choice. And our duty is just to lift up the name of Jesus Christ. Yes. That is what we strive to do right here at Choice Radio. All those who are praying for us, that we are continue to able to hold up a standard for the Word of God with integrity. We thank you indeed. Anybody who will be calling the phone, we'd like you to be calling on the topic that we'll be discussing right about now. If there is anything to be discussed that does not pertain to the topic, we'll allow ask you to call after the program is over, that you can insert your information or whatever it is, your question. So if you're calling and it's not pertaining to the subject matter at hand, we'd like you to do everything in decency and in order and do it off the air. On the air will be designated for those who are involving with the conversation at hand today. The phone number here is 347-663-8638. And the question that we are asking today, can watching worldly television or listening to worldly music affect your Christian walk? Can it affect? Will it affect? Does it make any difference? I want to hear from you. We want to hear what's going on. So the number 213-493-0146, if you're out there in Radio Land. We'd like to hear your conversation as we open it up right about now. And we go to the very first caller. Caller, good morning. You're live.
Good morning, my brother.
Morning, my sister. How are you doing?
Oh, thank God for today. I'm blessed and highly favored.
Amen. Glory to God.
I like the topic. I already spoke about this many times. But it is a yes. It ain't need no if and but with this question. Because as a Christian, he said you have to serve him in spirit and in truth. And you can't have one foot in, so you're serving the Lord, and the other foot out. That's the reason why I don't really, really watch televisions. I don't even listen to news. Somebody would come and tell me in the house what was said, because I think they're distracting me. As a Christian, I am. I'm a believer in Christ. I love the Lord wholeheartedly. Peace here, peace there. You know, sometimes in the home, the kids do things and you talk. But being a Christian, there are some things that showing on the television that you don't need to watch. Because sometimes they take up with watching television and they forgot to read the Bible. They forgot not just read it.
Hold on, caller.
So I think it's better if we Christians find time to be deeper in the Word than sit back watching television, are going to places that will distract you, because nobody is perfect. There is no perfect person out there, and it doesn't matter how strong some people think they are, and they go and watch television, some show or something, they get carried away. They might go to their relative's house for some function, and then the music isn't the right music, and they shake a leg. So you need is not be saying, oh, I'm a Christian, but I'm not. No, that's a lie. It's so, best you study the Word, understand it. If you don't, you call somebody else who has more knowledge and you ask them, let us study it and explain it for me. And this is my contribution. God bless.
Amen. So you're saying, caller, that it does have an impact, that it will affect you?
Yes, it will.
Amen. Thank you for your contribution. All right.
You're welcome.
Hey, caller, you're next. Good morning to you.
Good morning, 00.
How are you doing?
I'm blessed and highly favored. How are you?
I'm great in the name of Jesus, my sister. Yes. Wow.
Yes, I see that you. I know you're not supposed to discuss anything else, but I just want to say that last night and this morning, I see you were under heavy anointing, and I just felt it here in the house, too.
Glory
so
to the
I want to give my my little input into what about television and the worldly music. First of all, we have to ask ourselves what's behind the music, what's behind it, what's going on television. TV is so immoral. And it's full of sensation, and it's empty. We don't, they're not offering anything that is of substance to us, at least in this, in our eternal walk. And I think we have to ask what's behind it. And we know it's the devil. But the devil doesn't show up he doesn't show his old face. So he has to come with a spirit of deception. So he comes like an angel of light, as the Bible said, to deceive us. And so we get caught up in television and all what's going on. But the Bible says that, you know, to give attention to what you see and what you hear. When we give attention to the things we give attention to is what comes out of us. So if we fill up ourselves with what's going on television, then we have no place for God. That's why we have so much weakness among Christians, because we give our attention to the wrong things. When we give our attention to the Word builds us and renews us and keeps us in that path where God wants us to be. But when we give our attention to television and what's going on, we get caught up in all the sensation and in all the emptiness that's going on television. Everything is transient. Everything is for temporary on television. And so we get caught up in this. Like we hear they were advertising this Black Friday so much that by the time the Friday came along, even before Friday, people were encamped outside of stores to get what? Things? So we, you know, that's what television does to us. That's what the world voices do to us. But when we get ourselves, and then another thing that the Bible said, broad is the way that leads to destruction. So when we get involved in those things, we get into that place of the broad way. When we get ourselves involved in the Word keeps us. And it's not like it's boring. The Bible, it's so beautiful, the life that we have in the Lord God. It's so wonderful, so that when we start to break away from those things of the world, we get into a place of fullness, of substance, of wonder. So I think that we should not be, as Christians, we should not be caught up in television and the things of the world, because at the end of the day, they bring death. We might not be dead physically, but that's where it's going anyway. But spiritually, it brings death. We're in a place of compromise. And I think, you know, we could watch a little television, just have an idea of what's going on around us. But it's where we focus. Where we focus is where we spend our precious time. Okay, I think I said enough.
Well, we thank you. We thank you for your contribution. You said quite a lot, and we definitely appreciate your contribution. So overall, you're saying that being a child of God, being a Christian, and indulging in television, worldly television, will affect your faith.
It will.
All right, my sister. Yeah. Thank you for your comment.
Oh, okay then.
All right. Caller, good morning. You're next.
Good morning, Doblo.
How are you doing, sir?
I'm doing great.
Amen.
Well, my contribution is that, as far as I'm concerned, television is just an entertainment device in the house with an off and on button, and there is programs. So I think having a television in the house is good, but it's a program that you choose to listen to and to watch. That will make the difference.
So you're saying it's not about we're talking about worldly television. So there is a distinction in what we watching.
Yeah, but I don't think we're looking at the television would affect our Christian walk based on the program we looked at, because we got to be there ready to not to fall back in the trap of the wicked with the unnecessary programs that we might watch. So we have to be aware and watch and listen to what we're paying attention to.
Amen. So in other words, caller, you're saying this, being selective in what we watch is what makes the difference, and not just the TV, the mere TV.
Correct. That's right. That's amen. Exactly what I'm trying to say.
All right, but overall, you're saying that the TV, if it's worldly and it's not for Christian content or something of moral value, it will have an effect on you.
It will have an effect on the program, not the television. Remember, the television is just a device. It's the programs that we pay attention to on the television.
Amen. So I think we walk in together. We walk in same way. I think we agree on the same thing, my brother. Thank you for your contribution.
You're welcome.
Amen.
Brother.
Hey, caller, good morning to you. How are you doing?
Praise God, 007. How are you?
I'm doing great in the name of Jesus, my sister.
Thank God. I believe that too much TV can hinder you from your growth in Christ. And it's not only what you watch, because watching TV is not sin. It's too much of it make it, you know, something wrong with it. Because, for example, I like to watch Law and Order because this happened to me before. And it's like you watch it and you don't want to miss an episode. And it take time, pull you away from reading the Bible. It when you're ready to go down and pray, you can't even pray. And those things just stop your growth. And then you see that you want to watch it every week and you want to watch it more and more. And when you go down, you don't even know what to say to God. And I thank God for Choice Radio, though, because a lot of time I feel like I get weak. And I pray, God sent an answer, and Him sent it right through you. And I said, thank God you heard me, you know. But too much TV is definitely will take you down, low, low, low. Because when you feel like you know everything and you have got wrap around your hand, He's just taking one step back and another step back. Until He's out and you're wondering what happened. You didn't do anything wrong. What caused this to happen? You get so weak. You know, but TV stop you. It's not only if you watch a gospel program or the news or just one episode of Law and Order. Too much of it will just stop your growth. You have to feed the spirit just like you feed your body. You have to feed your spirit. Because when I was feeding my spirit, I strong, and nobody cannot tell me anything. You cannot bring any conversation to me. Same way you feed your body, you have to feed your spirit. That's my little bit I have to say about it.
Thank you for the call. So you definitely say it does make a difference with watching the worldly television. It does have an impact.
Big difference.
All right, my sister. Thank you for your contribution in the name of Jesus.
Bye.
All right. Hey, caller. All right, that caller there. 347-663-8638. And the question we're asking, can worldly TV create an impact in your Christian walk? I know many of you have begged to differ this morning, and we just like to take our time out and give you a chance to air what you want to air, because we know we all have different opinions and we all relate to God in different ways. We are different people. But like I said, whatever conversation we hold on Choice Radio, this station right here is for the edifying of the saints of God. We are here for the perfecting of the saints, that we will experience all that God has without any hindrance. Hey, caller, good morning to you.
Double O, you're ball with Bridget Moss.
How are you doing, my
Double
son?
Double O.
Yes.
You see what I have to say? Sam Cooke, you know, Sam Cooke did sing a lot. Remember, he was in the church and sing a lot of Christian music. And when he come on, you know what I say? He started singing worldly music. And he died. I said to my son-in-law the other day, you know that killed Sam Cooke? What's the most good I have one cassette as Sam Cooke with gospel music right there? Well, it's been so nice. You know when it come out, right? All the church, yeah? And start to sing the worldly music. So I said to my son, that's why if I say every day you play gospel music, I only say gospel station, I really, that's what it means. I don't want television. I don't know. I don't want television. That is what I don't know.
So you're saying that the world, the television can have an effect in your Christian life?
Yeah, I feel that, yes. Hear me, I did have Dennis Brown music, you know I was a music man. I give all of them, I give all of those CDs. I feel the godly, new and godly music and the godly and the television can affect you with a Christian life. You read the Bible, CD, right now, pastor said he won't be to come on a radio station to play some gospel CD for him.
All right. So we thank you, my brother, for the contribution in the name of Jesus. We thank you for your contribution, my brother, in the name of Jesus. We love you.
Yes, man, and I love you too.
And keep holding on to God's unchanging hands.
I was in church last week.
You cry?
Lord, yep.
The love of God is so strong, my brother. You have no choice to let it out when he hugs you up. Yes, when he hugs you up.
I happy man, Carl. I'm going to go and list you. For no man call.
Amen. Thank you, brother.
All right, my brother.
Amen.
All right.
34 minutes on the other side of 11 o'clock. I know many people will beg to differ with the conversation this morning. You're all day in Radio Land. Can worldly television and worldly association, worldly music, has any impact on your Christian growth, your Christian walk, your Christian stability? Does it affect you? Can it affect you? Will it affect you? Or is nothing wrong with a little this here, a little that, a little dabble here, a little dabble there? No big deal. I'm strong in Christ. What do you say? 347-663-8638. Go and give us your input. Let us hear what angle you're coming from. That we all can learn and edify each other in the body of Christ. You know, especially sometimes husbands and wife, one person have one perspective and the next person scratching their head to get it with the other side, and they can't get it across. The next person is convinced in their way of thinking. 347-663-8638. If you already let your voice be heard this morning, can worldly television and worldly association with musical program or such has any impact on your Christian walk, your godly connection? 347-663-8638. Caller, you are next. Good morning.
Good morning.
How are you doing, my sister?
I'm great.
That's nice.
It's so good to hear your program this morning.
Amen. Glory to the name of Jesus, my sister.
My contribution is television is really, really detrimental to people's life. But you also have a choice. There is channels you can turn on and turn off. We all have the ability to turn the television on and off. Elderly people can do that because there is a screen in front of them and they would not be able to maneuver the television. But as young people or people in their right mind, they have to know what to look at and what not to look at. And we as Christians must know, have to know, what you must look at and what you mustn't look at. That's my contribution, and God bless you. You're doing a very good job.
All right, we give praise to God. Before you go, you made a couple of statements in between. You say you kind of on the borderline of yes or no. If it does affect you, you basically stated that, you know, according to what you watch, it doesn't make a difference. It kind of, you know, what are you really saying?
I am saying it could affect you.
It could or will.
It could affect you.
It will affect you, and affect you.
It would and it could.
Mm-hmm.
But we as Christians have the ability and the spirit in us to know what to watch. And even if you have kids, you have to monitor them because you want them to be filled with the Holy Spirit. So I am saying television is really, really affecting especially the youths.
Amen. Thank you, my sister.
Thank you.
Amen.
God bless.
And I say from time to time we bring some conversation that you might not hear on the normal, you know, wouldn't hear it, but, you know, because it's just what it is. Many people are definitely concerned about offending folks. And we know that the word of God will offend even the giver or the receiver. That's why it's stated that the word is like a two-edged sword. It didn't say two handles. It didn't say two-sided. Two-edged sword. Double-edged. But we know it's important that we bring it out from time to time, that we can remind us where we're going. And we know many of us are taking different, you know, things inside, and we have it, we hold it dear to us. That's why we want to open it and have people, you know, share from different walks, different segment of the aisle, so we can come to a conclusion. Caller, good morning.
Hello, good morning.
How are you, my sister?
I'm pretty good.
You're pretty good.
I'm listening. I'm good. You
Amen.
Know, I'm listening to your program this morning. Although I'm on a run, I'm making a quick call.
Amen.
You hit it right in the heart about as a Christian to watch every and everything. A Christian not supposed to watch every and everything on TV. My husband is a Christian, and he watch everything on TV, and he driving me nuts in my house, in my apartment. You don't know, peace to pray, TV, all kind of vampire eating up people, man stabbing, shooting and killing, and all sort of things. And it is very annoying, and I don't think it is a good idea as a Christian to watch every and everything on TV. I can't talk, Lord, because he's in the other part. You know, I think it draws you away from God. What time you have to meditate? You have 1 foot out there, and you have 1 foot in the kingdom, 1 foot in the world, and 1 foot in the kingdom. And at the same time, there's other Christians around. You can't function because of your behavior.
Wow. Hey, caller, I thank you for calling and making that disclaimer right there this morning. And that is the core of the question. We're not just talking about individual with an individual perception, but we're looking at the places where people have to be with people who have a different, you know, belief or a different take on the matter, when one person totally is on one side of the aisle and the other person is totally on the other side. But you see, that's where the distinction comes from, being a Christian and be filled with the Holy Spirit. The distinction is right there based on what you're saying. If you ever come in contact with this Holy Spirit, from this Jesus of Nazareth that we're talking about, it's no way in the world that you could entertain worldly television and watch everything and anything. It just don't work. It just cannot work. It don't work. But I want you to keep praying. Keep praying for him. Keep praying for him, my sister, that he will come into alignment, and pray that the Holy Spirit will come in him. Because once he have the Holy Spirit, then he will be able to make the right decision. All right, my sister?
Yes, thank you very much.
Thank you very much. God bless you. Amen. 1142 347-663-8638. You out there in Radio Land, and you know that you think, you beg to differ. Please call us up and let us hear what's going on. What do you feel? Can worldly television and worldly music association affect your Christian faith, your Christian walk? Will it take away? Does it make any difference? Because you are strong in Christ. 347-663-8638. At the conclusion, we're going to give you a couple of scriptures that we can take into consideration as to what the Bible asks us to do, or what is the Bible's recommendations as believers. And one of the reasons why we, you know, come with a certain conversation is really and truly that we want to prove that God that we're talking about is not a liar. He's not a liar. He's not a man that he should lie. Because many times we might feel that we are not seeing God. We are not hearing from God. God is not working in our lives. But we are not paying attention to what we put before God, or what we put in our life, what we are harboring in our spiritual life that might be hindrance in our growth. Because I am here to tell you that God is, yes, and those who diligently seek him and those who walk in the spirit and not in the flesh will see all the glory of the great God that we're talking about. This God is worthy to be praised. 347-663-8638. And we say, woe be unto the leaders that lead my sheep astray and refuse to stop, thus said the Lord, the truth of the word of God, for fear of offending people. Woe be unto you, your day is coming. Hallelujah, Jesus. God is not slack to keep his promise. Glory to the name of Jesus. Caller, good morning.
Yes, good morning. I agree with the last caller who just called. Myself, I call television a one-eye demon. It affects what you hear, what you see, even in the radio, certain programs, what people do not understand. When you're looking at those things, the demonic spirit in the program influence the people who are watching it. This is why it's called media. It's a medium. So like you said, if you come in contact with the Holy Spirit, there are certain places, certain things, you just cannot stay. You don't feel comfortable with it because you cannot serve two masters. So that other sister, I know what she's going through. Myself, somebody comes to my house, I don't have a TV. I got rid of my TV. When it turns to digital, I said, I don't have to pay people to poison my mind. So I got rid of it. Praise the Lord. When somebody comes to my house, if I'm playing my music, you put on something that I don't like, I politely say, please, I don't want it. Because when you leave, I have to deal with the demonic forces. I have enough to deal with. I don't invite them. Praise the Lord.
So, caller, you saying that the worldly television will have an impact on a Christian life?
Yes, definitely. But furthermore, when you even the Christian program on TV can have an effect on you, because the stuff that they are showing is a disgrace to the gospel. Even that too can affect a person's way of thinking, because it's all right. You can do it too. Yes, not just worldly program. Some of the Christian program, to me, it's a disgrace to the word of God.
Amen.
The things that the people preach, there is no people can use this, that medium to perpetrate hatred and things like that. No, it's wrong. Putting people in bondage. Even that, those program too, I think TV, you should get rid of it, period. Period.
All right, my sister, thank you for your contribution.
You're welcome.
Amen. Bye-bye. 347, we're still waiting for those counteraction callers. We know you're out there in Radio Land. We know you beg to differ. 347-663-8638. We know you're out there in Radio Land. We want to hear your view this morning. 347-663-8638. Caller, good morning. Caller, good morning.
Good morning.
How are you doing?
I'm awesome.
Amen.
It's so funny that I wake up this morning and I turned the radio on and that was the topic. Because this whole week I was struggling with something of that sense. And I kind of relate to the lady a while ago, because when you're a Christian and the other half is not really there yet, it makes some stuff kind of difficult. I don't care how strong we are as children in God. So it so happened that this weekend there was a function and it was a certain place I didn't want to go. And then my other half said, every time I'm going out, I'm always going by myself and everybody's there with their wife and you're not even there and all of that stuff. And I said, well, the places that this stuff has been held is not a place of interest for me. And the kind of music that's been played, I don't want to hear it. Saying that to say, and it's crazy how stuff like this can happen. And I'm saying, wow, am I setting my husband out there for other stuff? And my spirit said to me, where is your faith? Where is your faith? Your faith is in the world, or your faith is of God? Saying that to say, I remembered having a conversation with my bishop, and even my grandmother, my household representative, and she's always said to me, the people you hang out with, the stuff you listen, the books you read, no matter how strong you are, it always affects your life, positive or negative. You see, when we are in the world, we do everything that the world do, and it seems okay and it seems straight. But as soon as you become a child of God and you take yourself back from a lot of stuff, criticism hits you. So I'm saying that to say, we got to be really careful what being put into our air, into our soul, into our heart, even from our own personal people. God bless. I hope this is a contribution.
Amen. Thank you, my sister, in the name of Jesus. And we're going to dig the first scripture right now from Philippians 4:8. It says, finally, brethren, whatsoever things are true, whatsoever things are honest, whatsoever things are just, whatsoever things are pure, whatsoever things are lovely, whatsoever things are of good report, if there be any virtue, and if there be any praise, think on these things. Those things which ye have both learned and received and heard and seen in me, do, and the God of peace shall be with you. Let's go back to the phone lines. Caller, good morning to you.
Yeah, good morning.
How are you doing?
I'm fine here in the RW. I just called to, I like the program about the television, but it's a scripture, Christianity, it's faith. It has nothing to do with television. If you want to watch television, you want to look, I watch television, and I read my Bible every day and do every 20 years, but I'm not a Christian. But I have faith in God. I know the Bible. So if you go to church, to worship God, you don't worship the church. God, most people think it's just the church. That is the God. So if you have faith, everything can come. So the television, some of the difference. Because me watch television, where they have some program, Christian program, with some guys that say something about the Bible. Why do they even know about God? Three Bible we have. I'm new with him. So it doesn't make a difference.
My brother, I thank you for your contribution. And let me make one statement to you this morning. I give praise to God for having you listen to this program and calling me up. My brother, let me say this to you very clearly. The Bible said a double-minded man is unstable in all his ways. Let me say this to you, my brother. I thank you for calling me. I thank you, my brother, for calling me this morning. Because, you know, let me tell you, my brother, let me tell you this thing from the book of Proverbs. I want you to check it out when you get off the phone. Proverbs.
I'll read Proverbs.
Yes, yes. Amen. Listen to me. Knowing is doing. Knowing is not just saying that you know. Knowing is doing. It's not just saying that you know. Proverbs 4.
We live in a sinful world.
Oh, so because you live
in a sinful world, you can't go sin. All of us live in sin.
Right. So let me ask you something, brother.
So if you live in a sinful world, how are you going to go through it? You have to have faith.
Right.
So if you have faith in the Bible and have faith in God, you will go through. Because by your work, you get pain. You know?
Right.
You can't plant corn and get peace. You have to just know where you want. So if you watch, so if them come with television, that's nothing different. So if you want to watch it, if you have Christianity, if you feel like you have God in you so much that you have to watch TV, that's good. But if you have faith enough to carry the cross, everything will be a copacetic.
All right, let me ask you something now. Let me just, I give you a chance to speak and let me make this statement to you. Are you born again?
No.
Oh, you're not born again?
No, but let me tell you something. My people, they must send the Adventists before me born. And me teach them still is that. But me follow the Bible. My follow the Bible. There's two parts of it, you know. You have good and bad. Me do the bad part of life, which is the worldly and part. So if you do the worldly and part, you have to serve Christ. You have to live out the worldly and part and serve Christ. You can't serve two masters at the same time. But you have some people.
Well, my brother, listen to me. You're answering the question for yourself. You just said you cannot serve two masters. My brother, listen to me. I thank you for calling me. I would like to take your number. I'd like to call you after the show is over. What's your phone number?
347.
Mm-hmm.
419.
419. 9988. What's your name?
Barry.
Okay, Barry. Barry, I love you in the name of Jesus. I thank you for calling me this morning. I'll give you a call, okay?
Okay, Sam.
Glory to the name of Jesus. Thank you, brother. Hey, caller, good morning.
Good morning, Brother Straker. How are you?
I'm great in the name of Jesus. How are you doing, my sister?
I am blessed and highly favored.
Amen. Stay that way. Talk to me.
I want to encourage the woman that called before. Before I got saved, I never used to get invited out by my husband to, like, parties. And soon after I got saved, the invitations started coming. You know, he started inviting me to the the year-end celebration that is normally have. So the first year I went, and then it didn't rest well with my spirit. So I said, okay, all right, I cannot be going around these things anymore, because I've been sitting there and I'm like, what am I doing here? I'm in the wrong place. I'm not supposed to be here. So the next year I told him, I said, you know, when we left there, I said, you know what, I don't want to go to those things anymore because now I'm a Christian. So the next year he went out, and he did get tickets, and he said, well, I already paid for the tickets. We can go, but we don't have to partake. We can just sit down. And I said, no, I don't want to go. I don't want to go, and I hold out. We didn't go. The next year he did the same thing, and guess what? The Lord delivered us because he got sick, and we didn't get to go. And from then, you know, he stopped, you know, coming and telling me about it and, you know, paying for tickets and stuff like that. Because, you know, the Word of God says that he wished that we were either hot or cold. If we lukewarm, he's going to spill us out of his mouth. We got to be consistent with our walk. We got to remember that our unsaved loved ones, they're looking at us. And if today we're partying and then tomorrow in the church and then we're up, we're down, we're wrong, what signal are we sending to them? And I thank God that I hold out with my Christian walk, and I'm consistent with my walk, and I draw the line, things that I would go to and I would not go to. And my husband is seeing the consistency in me, and I'm happy about that, because he himself, he said to me, you know, you are too holy. And the first time he said that to me, I felt bad. But then the Holy Spirit dealt with me, and he spoke to me, and he said, okay, don't feel bad. It's nothing for you to feel bad, because he's seeing something inside of you. Would you have preferred for him to say you're a hypocrite? And, you know, that jog my memory, said, no, I don't want nobody calling me a hypocrite, because I don't want doing something today or saying one thing and then doing something else. So I just want to encourage that person, the sister before, that, you know, don't feel no way you're not going to lose out. God is on your side and he's going to protect you. You don't have to go to these places with your husband. You're not going to lose your husband. God is on your side. We serve a great, big, mighty God.
All right, thank you for the contribution, my sister, as we're going to go in and establish the second scripture for the day. And we're going to... we're going to go to Romans 8. Romans 8 and 4. He said that the righteousness of the law might be fulfilled in us who walk not after the flesh, but after the spirit. For they that after the flesh to demand the things of the flesh, but they Romans 8 and 4. Read it. Romans 8 and 4.
and the righteousness of the Lord might be fulfilled to us who walk after the flesh, but after the Spirit. For they are after the flesh, do mind the things of the flesh, but they that are after the Spirit, do the things of the Spirit. For to be carnally minded is death, but to be Spirit, usually minded is like peace. But because the carnal mind is enmity against God, for it is not subject to the law of God, neither indeed can be. So then, that are in the flesh cannot please God. Glory to the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Spirit, if so be that the Spirit of God dwell in you. Now, if any man have not the Spirit of Christ, he is none of his. Glory to the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. But if the Spirit of him that raised up Jesus from the dead dwell in you, he that raised up Christ from the dead shall also quicken your mortal bodies by his Spirit that dwelleth in you. Hallelujah, Jesus. Oh, glory to the name. Oh, Lord. Oh, my God. Hallelujah, Jesus. Oh, God, you're worthy. Hallelujah. Therefore, brethren, we are debtors not to the flesh, to live after the flesh. For if ye live after the flesh, ye shall die. Oh, hallelujah. Oh God, hallelujah. Glory to the name of Jesus this morning. We just thank you, Lord. We just thank you, Lord. Get that scripture, Romans 8 and 4, and go to, if you are born again, if you are in Christ, that is where you go to validate your Christian walk. I don't care who you are this morning. I don't care what you think of yourself. I don't care who you think you are. But if that's where you stand, baby, get into that scripture right there. Glory to the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. For as many are led by the Spirit of God, they are the sons of God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. let's go back to the phone. Now we're going to take a few more calls and we're going to shut it down. Caller, good morning to you.
Good morning, Brother Dablo.
Good morning.
Praise God for you.
Hallelujah.
This is what Jesus needs. Jesus needs us to humble ourselves. This is my word this morning. They have a phrase that said, curse like a sailor. I used to curse like a sailor. And I accept Jesus. No, I cannot hear it. I don't watch television. Listening to music outside, when you listen to those music, it sends you way back that you think when you was young. This is how I used to dance. This is how I used to feel. So the devil is working through all of that. So it will disturb Jesus. It will disturb your way to Christ. You understand?
Amen. So you're saying it will affect your faith.
Jesus wants us to have one foot in the door, the other foot still in the door. Not one foot outside, one foot inside. And when you follow in Jesus, things that you used to do, you do them no more. You cannot hear it. You cannot see it. So he works with you, and you can be both-sided. If you doing things like this, it don't matter. Jesus wouldn't accept that. You're either for him or you're against him. And I pray to God that he strengthen you and give you peace and glory.
Thank you, my sister, in the name of Jesus. Hey, caller, you're next. Good morning.
Good morning.
Could you please turn off your radio, ma'am?
I'm sorry. Hi, good morning, my dear brother.
I'm good, my sister. Sorry. Could you please turn off your radio, ma'am?
I'm trying to do that. Oh, my God, yes. I'm calling about regarding the subject you're talking about, Christian watching television.
Mm-hmm.
My view is that I believe as Christians, we have to choose our program, because there's also some educational program on television that you could also watch. Choose our program. And there are a lot of times we as Christians, we're not, maybe not watching television, but we might be reading the wrong books. We might be going to the wrong places. And sometimes stay on the phone and gossiping and doing things that is not of God. Lying, gossiping, doing all these things. So my thing is that as Christians, we just have to choose our program. Don't let the TV get into our way that we cannot get into the Word of God. Or let the telephone get into the way as we get into the Word of God. Don't make nothing that causes us to separate ourselves from God, you know, be a part of our life. Not necessarily only television only. There's other things that is preoccupying our time than the television. Right, brother? So, you know, one of the main things as Christians, we have to be careful. And a lot of Christians have to be so careful with, you know, biting against each other, gossiping against each other. The world is watching us. The world is watching every move we make. Sitting down on our own home watching a television program, the world may not be watching us, watching some educational program or what is going on in the world. There's news that we need to look at also, where we could pray for different things that's taking place in the world.
All right,
okay,
my sister.
So we have to choose our program.
Amen. So I thank you for your contribution. But at the top of the program, if you listen what I said, is that we're talking about worldly television. We're not talking about TV with something that you want to, you know, educate yourself, edify yourself, or something.
No,
with,
but there are people that come on there and talk about, they don't watch television. They just turn off the television and they, you know, spend more time in the Word and all these things. So it's not to say somebody has to turn the television off completely. But there are people that figure, okay, just turn it off altogether.
Well, let me say this to you, my sister, in defense of those who have made up their mind to walk with Jesus wholly and solely. This is basically what God is asking us to do. Because the thing about it is really, if something will cause you to stumble, why do you cause it to cause it to stumble? Now, if you it wouldn't cause you to stumble and you are, you know, disciplined enough and know what amount of poison you can take, because the FDA allow a certain amount of poison in the food. So the same way, if we are in this world, but we are not of this world. So we are not trying to say that we should not watch the news or not know what's going on or not have an idea of what's taking place in the world. So that was never the topic, and this would never be the topic, because we ask God for wisdom and integrity, and we know we wouldn't bring such a program to the radio to say that we shouldn't watch TV. I watch TV, and we all find something in TV that we can watch, but we're talking about worldly TV, because there are people who justify that watching a little soap opera here, there, everywhere, you know, it's not a big deal, because, you know, they have it going on. They have it going on with God. So those things does not affect them. They feel that they can handle a little bit of this and a little bit of that. So we're asking in general, does those things of the world have any impact on your Christian walk?
Okay. Well, I was supposed to say there are some programs that people will watch that you have people that said, okay, I could watch this program, but
no, we're talking about you. We're asking you. You as an individual.
Oh yes, I could sit down and watch a TV program. I mean, I'm not into the soap water business. Okay? But if I want to watch like certain shows like, you know, Housewives, or I want to watch Lifetime and those kind of shows, I could watch them show, because I know my walk with the Lord.
Mm-hmm.
I know my walk with the Lord.
You know your walk with the
Lord.
You know
what I'm saying?
So
where I'm walking with the Lord. I don't let this program corrupt my mind or take me away from the things of God.
So you're saying that those programs will not affect your faith?
No, it would not affect my faith based on how much I'm putting into my system.
How much
if you're putting into my system? If I'm going to serve the program and neglect God, neglect the word of God, then that's a different... That's a mess. We are going to be, you know, making a mess in our spiritual life there.
So let me ask you one more thing.
We can't just get up every day and watch a TV program, watch the soap water and everything, and don't feed ourselves with the word of God. We have to feed ourselves with the word of God.
Okay, so is the program moral or immoral?
As I said, it's based upon what program people want to watch and how you make it affect you. If I find I'm watching soap water and it's affecting me, taking me away from the word of God, I'm going to stop it. Because I'm like, this is not, you know, it's affecting my life. But if somebody else is watching it and it's not affecting their Christian life, then it's up to them to know how to deal with that.
So, you, in other words, you said
that... Once you find it's bothering your Christian faith, you have to stop.
How do you know it's bothering your Christian faith?
Because what happened is that you might watching the TV, watching it all the time, and you're like, oh my God, I couldn't tell when I took up the Bible and read the Bible. I couldn't tell when, you know. So what happened is that the your conscience start to take on all of you, you know, or the Holy Spirit convict you. Listen, you're spending too much time in front of this program. When last did you read my word?
Hallelujah, my sister. Father God, we just thank you for my sister on the phone. I thank you for just being honest, my sister. God is a good God and he's a faithful God. Father, we just pray for my sister right now that she's going to just, you know, commit herself more to you. She's going to dedicate herself more to you, Almighty God. Father, we know that we walk in the flesh, Lord, and we know that we are not perfect, God, but we are willing to surrender to your Holy Spirit that is going to lead us into all truth, Almighty God. So, Father, I just thank you for my sister for giving that testimony right there. And hope that you will continue to bring her into the fullness of your Holy Spirit, that she will walk with you in holiness. Thank you, my sister, for your call. All right?
God bless you, my dear brother.
God bless you, my sister.
Bye.
Amen. Okay. Bye-bye. Caller, good afternoon.
Good afternoon, 007.
Yes, ma'am.
I'm making a quick call again. I'm still running, and the man in the room there.
Amen.
He doesn't understand. When you change your life, you're out here was a cuss, bad word cuss all these years, and you accept Jesus Christ in your life and make a change. And when your partner go sit down in the house and watch people cursing bad word and fighting on TV and sexing and all those things, and then put on their clothes and come to church, it is not easy. And when you talk, you're disturbing them and you're nagging them and so. Your Holy Spirit. spirit cannot work as how the Holy Spirit is supposed to work with two people. And then you know, can't pray together, you know, can't hold on to pray together, and you're hooked to your TV, your first wife, you better tell your TV is your first wife, because I don't talk back and all those kind of foolishness. It hurt. I'm sorry I'm on a run, I can't get to talk to you because I need prayer in my house. But I will talk to you another time, sir.
Yeah,
watching TV is good, but no, watch every garbage. Yes, there's educational things, Dr. Oz and other things that I watch. But if he's a man of God or a woman of God, you draw to the things of God. This man not even watch gospel station. I alone wasn't gospel station. I listen to you and tell him some of the things that you said. He's in there hugging up his TV. So pray for me.
Well, you should put it. Well, going to church. Let me tell you something, my sister. Going to church doesn't mean that you save. And let me just say that very clearly. Going to church does not mean that you save. It does not mean nothing. Going to church have nothing to do with being of God. Going to church have zero to do with God, because you could be in the church and don't have the Holy Spirit with you. And that's what we're trying to say this morning. We're just trying to ignite something within us that we will know where we are in Christ. Because you see, my sister, like I said before, I have come into Christ and know that Jesus is as good as the words say. Everything that God tells us is just as it is. Nothing is different. Everything that God has promised us is available to us. But you see, there are many people who are not receiving from God, and they're making God look like a liar in the eyes of the unbeliever. And we are going to stand against that, because we know that this God is a real and good God. So our intention is to go through and find out what it is that we might be doing that could be a hindrance and is a hindrance in the body of Christ for God to have his full way in our life. So we are looking that we are able to help people to know that God is not a liar. You have a part to play in seeing the manifestation of God in your life, but you must submit. You must submit to the ways of God. If you have not submitted to God, the Holy Spirit cannot dwell in you. So you could be doing things because of habit. You're doing it because your wife wanted to do it, your husband wanted to do it, but you're not doing it because the Holy Spirit is not in you. You have not really accepted Christ as your Lord and Savior. So going to church doesn't mean that you save. It has zero to do with it. Zero, zero, zero. So my sister, listen to me. Remember, this is a personal walk. And when you die, your husband is not going to go with you. You're going to go by yourself. I would encourage you to continue to pray to God that the Holy Spirit is going to quicken your husband, that he's going to come into the light, come into the truth, because there is something in your house, there is something going on, there is demons in there is evil spirit in there that is encamping in your house, that is keeping this man in a way, and he is not totally submitting to the Holy Spirit that he's able to make an adjustment in his life. It's not him that is doing it. He's not him that is doing, my sister. It's zero to do with your husband. Zero. He have no control over what is going on. He have no control over him. So you gotta keep praying for him. Keep, when he lay down in the night, go to his bed and pray with him and hold his hand and pray for God and do some fasting and submit yourself that the Holy Spirit is going to direct you what to do, how to ignite something in him. And I would encourage you to also get people to talk to him. Set them up to meet up with him some way and make a conversation to allow him to change his disposition about being a Christian. All right? Give me a call back when the program is over. Give me a call back when the program is over.
Okay.
God is good, my sister. Glory to God. Thank you. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. We thank you, Father. 17 minutes after 12 o'clock. We're going to shut down the phone at 12:30. But like I said, the reason why we're doing the program and we're opening the question is because it is mainly designated to people who live with other people and has to function with them. And one person is seeing God on that plane, and the next person seeing God on that plane, and they cannot find the thing that... Because you see, what the devil mostly wants is to have a divided house. Listen to me, God honors marriage. Let me tell you, you don't have no idea. God honors his word. And you see, when somebody is married, you're talking about a powerhouse. You're talking about power that can shake the very core, the foundation of the world. And when a husband and a wife is completely under submission to the Holy Spirit. You talking about power, you're talking about healing, you're talking about everything, because this is what God has ordained. So the enemy is really against married couples. So married couples is a big target, because you see, if the devil can come and visit one person in the house, you know there is not too much you can do. Remember, Jesus couldn't perform much miracles when he go places where there were unbelievers. It's the same thing then, it's the same thing now, and it's the same thing that will continue. That's why the Bible say what was then is now and to come. Look at this right here. Back in the days with the Pharisees, when Jesus came, there were people who they like him to a certain level, they admire him at a certain level, but they still were not willing to submit themselves to him as being of God. Now the Bible said what was then is now. We have religion now that is saying that they are saved by grace through Jesus Christ, but yet they are denying the power of Jesus Christ being the only way to the Father. They still want to hold on to the laws. You understand? So what was then is now. The Bible said in the beginning, so it shall be in the end. So we come on the radio because we want to let people know that you have to make up your mind. Are you going to walk in the Spirit or are you going to walk in the flesh? You see what I'm saying? So what was then, it's now. But it doesn't look the same way, because unless you have submitted. The Bible says, look, submit to God, resist the devil, and he's going to flee. If you are not submitting to God, it means you are leaving room for the devil to fight with your mind as to what you should follow. There are even pastors of evangelical systems that still have some sort of adoration for the Sabbath. Because they might be a pastor and they still don't understand really the difference between law and grace. And the Bible said that he will use the foolish thing to confound the wise. There are many people who listen to me and want to know, where did I study? Where did he go? Who gave him the authority? Well, the authority is given by the Lord Jesus Christ. And he told you that in the last day, he's going to pour out on all flesh. I am part of all flesh. I am not ashamed of the gospel of Jesus Christ. We are only saved by Jesus Christ. Nothing else. There is nothing else that man could have done then, before Jesus came, that will present them before God as holy. That is the reason why Jesus came. And I'm saying this to somebody this morning, you're listening to me, and you still lean into your own understanding or to your own indoctrination. What was not accomplished by the law is now accomplished by grace through Jesus Christ. The Bible said a double-minded man is unstable. You cannot believe that Jesus is your way to the Father and still believe that there is something that you can physically do out of yourself to get you into the Father's house. It means you are not putting your full confidence in Jesus Christ. And I'm saying to you, this is what is going on. Because the Bible tells us, what was then is now. If there is a counterfeit, there is also something that is real. Hence the reason for a counterfeit. So I'm saying this to open the eyes of all those out there in radio land who are looking at evangelicals and feel that we are in the wrong and you are in the right. If you are of God, you must know that we also are of God, because we are seeking the same God that you are seeking. You cannot condemn us and claim to be with God. It's the same thing. When Jesus walked the earth, the Pharisees still could not see him as a man of God, although all he was doing was good. He loved his Father. Why would he violate his own Father on the Sabbath day? And many people don't understand. A lot of miracles that Jesus performed was performed on the Sabbath day to make a distinction and make something that they could understand. But still they were not willing to understand, because they were not walking with God. When they brought the woman and said they caught her in adultery. Adultery is performed with two parties. Yet you bring one person. Where is the other person?
So Jesus tried to prove to them that you are not true. You are fake. You are not of my Father. My Father is a just God. So if you bring someone before me for adultery, where is the other party? It takes two. Glory to the name of Jesus. So I'm saying this to make that contrast to you. That is just a kind of sideline right here. The Holy Spirit just, like, you know, just quickened this in my spirit right here now to make this distinction that we want people who want Jesus to break away from the indoctrination, because you cannot love two people at the same time. Even if you like one for their cooking, or you like one for the way they present themselves, one might be better looking. It means you are separating your love from one to another. Even if one is getting 99%, one is getting 1%, it still means you are not giving 100%. And God is asking us to give 100% to Jesus. So you cannot believe in a system that you have to do something to please God and still saying that you believe is through His Son that you are saved. And this is just what it is. You know, so we need people to understand that Jesus is the only way that you and I have any conversation to do with our Father. It's the only way. Because if the law was perfect then, and men could have done it and achieved grace through Jesus Christ, there was no need for Jesus. If there was no need to send somebody else, they would have lived it just like that. Everything would have been just the same. If our forefathers could have done it, there was no need for Jesus. That is why Jesus had to come. Let me make one more thing for you to pay attention to, believers in Radio Land. The reason why the temple that everybody used to go to worship, where the Holy of the Holy was there, the Ark of the Covenant, everybody had to go to that one place to worship God. And the high priest was to go behind the veil. That was everything that they had back in the day. That was that. When the veil was rent in two, it means that it's very significant that we don't need you no more. We don't need no other high priest, because Jesus is our only high priest. We don't need nobody who we cannot trust in no more. We don't need no hypocrite parasite and hypocrite Pharisees who want to pretend themselves holy to the public, and while they're inside is like dead men bones. So we have to understand the Bible. We have to understand what the Bible is saying to us. Because we would be walking in bondage and still not coming out in the liberty to which Jesus Christ had set us free. So I hope that this little thing will give you something you can go and check it out and look and see what God is saying to us. Because He wants us to be free, brethren. He wants us to be free in the name of Jesus. And freedom can only be found in the Lord Jesus. All right? Now, to go back to our topic this morning, we're going to take something from the book of Psalms, Psalms 1. It said, "Blessed is the man that walketh not in the counsel of the ungodly, nor standeth in the ways of sinners, nor sitteth in the seat of the scornful, but his delight is in the law of the Lord, and in his law doeth he meditate day and night. And he shall be like a tree planted by the rivers of water that bringeth forth fruit in his due season." All right? So this is very important that we understand that you cannot be a friend of the world and still be a friend of God. It's a big, big, big distinction on what is going on. So we just want to put this out there. You go ahead and focus on these scriptures. I'm going to give you a few more scriptures. We're getting ready to shut down the phone. I'm going to take one or two more callers, and then we're going to conclude this segment. Caller, good morning.
Good morning, my brother. Well, what I have to say is Christians should be Christians. I don't really watch television. It doesn't really entice me. It's something educational. Yes, I watch the gospel channels. I listen to Choice Radio. But if you're a Christian, I cannot understand how you're going to be enticed by something that's immoral. You know, you could watch something that's of the world. It doesn't bother you. It doesn't bother your spirit. You know, I know I would be crucified by this, but I don't even allow my children to watch worldly stuff on the television. My son is a teenager. I don't allow him to play certain games. You know, God is God. And if we're Christians, we must be Christians. We must live a life that is Christ-like. You know, we can't be enticed by the things that are of the world and the things that are not of the world. Your walk must be right with God. Because the things that used to happen in the past when Jesus was on the world, on the earth, why can't we as Christians attain those things? You know what I mean? Because we're dabbing in the things that are not of Christ. And we're going to say, it doesn't bother me. It does bother your spirit. Don't be fooled. It does bother your spirit. Our walk must be right with Christ. You can't tell me you're going to be watching MTV. You're going to be watching Housewife or Basketball's Wife or whatever the other things are. And you're still calling yourself a Christian, a Christian. We must be Christ-like.
Amen.
We must be Christ-like.
Amen, my sister.
Hallelujah.
Glory to the name of Jesus this morning. And that is, thank you for the call, my sister. And that is the big distinction with where we can find out if we are in Christ or we are not of Christ. To everybody listening to the radio between me and you personally right now, I'm going to tell you the honest truth. If you are in this Jesus I'm talking about, there are certain things that will just make you want to vomit. There are things that will make you want to just throw up when you see people react and say they are Christian. That is my experience. I don't know about you. I don't know about you. I don't know about you. You know your God? Good for you. You know your Jesus? Hey, hallelujah. You know your Bible? Hallelujah. But I know that if you are filled with this Holy Spirit that we talking about, is no way you can sit down and tolerate hours upon hours of all kind of immorality and cheating and all kind of stuff like that. Zero. That's just really what it is to me. So I don't know, you know, there are many spirits gone out into the world and, you know, he has transformed into an angel of light and deceiving men and women out there in Radio Land. And like I said, the Bible said, many are called and few are chosen. You know, it doesn't make no difference to me. I am not on the radio to find no friend and favor and a bunch of fans, everybody, OW7. Man, I couldn't care less about that. I care about the gospel of Jesus Christ being preached to you guys, that you know that our Lord and Savior died to give you something that you could not achieve without the blood being shed on the cross. And you need to pay attention to it and be serious to it and respect it for what it is. Because there is no two ways in serving God. There is no two ways. And this is a marker for a Christian to know, am I in Christ or am I not in Christ? Because you cannot be in Jesus Christ and engage and involve with everything in the world and still call yourself a saint. You could call yourself a Christian because many came to Christ. Many, many, many came from all walk of life, but they were not saints. It's a big distinction right there. And we're not trying to come down on anybody, because you know what happened? Once your intention is right and you want to find the Lord, it's good. We know we all seeking the Lord, and it's not to condemn anyone. But I feel that this is a very distinguished marker that a person can tell, am I in Christ? Am I with the Holy Spirit? Because I tell you, man, there are places that I go and I will just, man, I want to vomit. I get a headache. Oh, God, I want to go. Oh, Lord, I can't stand it. And this is what I have experienced. So I don't know for you. I don't know for you. I do not know for you. A person who say he or she is a Christian, and on Thanksgiving Day, you come out and say you're giving food to people and feel that you're doing God any good, and you have the Holy Spirit in you, and that don't tell you, you should be ashamed of yourself. You don't have the Holy Spirit. Glory to the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Glory to the name of Jesus. Glory to the name of Jesus. It doesn't make no difference. To me personally, we appreciate every single person who listens to Choice Radio. We appreciate you. But like I said, for me personally, it is very important that we stand on the word of God. This is what we need. We need reality. We don't need no, just, you know, a hype that doesn't have nothing behind it. a hype and a bag of talk that have nothing behind it, no power. Come on! The God we serve is a God of power. Hallelujah! There is no healing in the church no more. There is no healing. Nobody getting healed. Nobody getting delivered. You're coming with your devil. You're going back with 10 devil more. No! Let us give God some credit. Let us give Jesus some credit, my brethren and sisters. And like I said today, this is a marker for all of us. All of us is a marker. We could find out if we are in Christ or if we are not in Christ. Because if you are in Christ, there are places, there are things that, oh my God, it gives you a headache. It makes you sick. You want to vomit when you hear it. That is my experience. And I just wanted to share that experience with you. I don't know if you have the same situation. You and your God have a different thing going on. Nothing wrong with that. I'm not trying to condemn you. But I'm just saying this has been my reality with my walk with God. And I encourage you, brethren, if you want to see the power of the Lord Jesus in your life, submit yourself to Him. Cut off from the world and take time with the Lord. Take time with the Holy Spirit. Even Christian television. In order to see a Christian function, you must have time and peace with yourself. So even Christian television should not be going 24 hours in your ear because it's Christian television. Because some people have a perception that they could just play the television and it could bring all the spirit into your house and bring all the abundance of God into your house. It's the same way like somebody feel because they have a Bible on their dashboard. For some reason, that Bible, without reading it, all the words and the power of Jesus will just illuminate your life. As the same way some people feel. If a man or woman is anointed, they want to get close to you, hoping that I could be unholy, but if my friend is holy and he or she is anointed, it's going to rub off on me. No, it cannot and will not. So we have to seek God for ourselves. Submit ourselves to God because He's knocking. He's knocking, He's knocking, He's knocking, He's knocking, He's knocking, He's knocking for us to open up to Him. I want to thank everybody who called this morning, and I just wanted to open that topic. And this topic this morning was mainly for couples, people who have to live with somebody else where everything is not unto their free will to do because they live in the same house with somebody else and they are seeing God in one way and the next person is seeing God in another way. Oh my God, I know the frustration. I understand the frustration. I understand the frustration. And this right there is what the devil do not want. The devil do not want a husband and wife who love the Lord and is married unto the Lord to ever come in unity and in unison to draw in that spirit of power. The devil don't want that because anytime that spirit is able to come in between a man and a woman who is in Christ, you're talking about miracle, you're talking about breakthrough, you're talking about deliverance, you're talking about explosion in the spiritual manifestation. And this is what the devil don't want. So we pray today that families, husband and wife, they are going to understand that there is something more that meet the eyes that is going to fight against your relationship, that is going to fight against your communication, that is going to fight its best to make sure that that man and that woman do not come in one at all, to ignite the power that is designated for those who married unto the Lord. So for the husband and wife, we just ask you that we have to both pray from both sides of the aisle and be conscious that whatever is trying to disturb us is more than more that is going on in the supernatural realm. There is much more that is going on in the spirit to try to hinder husband and wife from really aligning in one, because that is power you're talking about. That is power. Glory to the name of Jesus. So we thank everybody who contributed today. During the segment, I will try to give out a few more scriptures that we could look and dwell in. And my brethren in Radio Land, let me say this. You know, it is important that from time to time we sit back, turn off the world and find out, am I in Christ? Am I really following Jesus? Do I love the Lord? If I die today or tomorrow, am I even close? It is important. It's important. It's very important. It's very important. And then we as believers who really love the Lord and have totally surrendered, we have to make up our mind to be separated unto the Lord. I'm telling you, we have to make up our mind to be separated. Because the thing about it is, if we start focusing on how people look at us and how people treat us, then it's going to also hinder us from really serving God in spirit and in truth. And I know how some people feel, because anytime people feel that, well, you think you're holy or you think you're more than this, you kind of take it back and bring it back to yourself and feeling guilty and feeling all kind of way. No. You have to make up your mind to know that, well, I don't care what you say, I am pleasing God. I am pleasing the Almighty God, and this is what matters most. Everybody who called this morning, I thank you guys for calling and sharing. And most of all, we thank you, those who are praying for Choice Radio, because I tell you, man, I've been in the world, and I am not going to come into Christ and act the same like in the world. No, there must be a difference. There must be a distinction. I'm not going to come into Christ and pretend again. No. I have made up my mind to follow Jesus. No turning back. And I tell you the truth out there in Radio Land, if you out there are going through the same kind of hardship and same kind of whatever, make up your mind, ban your belly, that we are going to do this. Because he had faced more temptation than you and I, and he was able to do it. He's not going to give us more than we can bear. So let us walk together. Let's hold on to God's unchanging hand, and he's going to see us through in the name of Jesus. Thank you once again.
Choice Radio. Your life. Your salvation. Your choice. Choice Radio.
Choice Radio. Here we go. Here we go. Yeah. 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 Want inspiration. Want to be lifted and refreshed. You got to turn your radio.
Choice Radio. Choice Radio.
Music brings healing, brings joy and life to the depressed. Oh, gotta keep on listening.
Take care of your body. If you don't take care of yourself, who will take care of you? So get Dr. Robert Brand Blood and Body Bitters. Dr. Robert's Red Blood Tonic fights off fat, cholesterol, itchy skin, and it nourishes the body to improve blood circulation. Livergen and Bynum-Amara contributes to keep the liver and blood healthy from toxin and the effects of diabetic and blood pressure medicines. Get Nervogen Tonic Powder, which helps to strengthen the nerves, brains, muscles, and even fosters better sleep. Dr. Robert's Diabetic Tonic helps to reduce blood sugar. Dr. Robert's brand flaxseed oil capsules and cordyceps contributes to healthy skin, healthier hair, body, face, and even provides a younger look and reduces cholesterol. Get Trout Hall brand carrot nectar and Mama Haiti brand mango nectar, full with more fruits and fibers than the other watered-down brands. Demand Dr. Robert's high-quality teas and products in order to enjoy great quality and save at the same time. Always purchase tip-top circle cheese. Yes, tip-top circle cheese makes 8 delicious sandwiches. Just add a little mustard and hot sauce in the tip-top cheese. On sale now in most West Indian food stores and supermarkets. Or by wholesale through AFN Brokers 908-486-0077 or IMP Food at 25 Brooklyn Terminal Market.
Choice Radio is a blessing and an inspiration to you. Write us at Choice Gospel Network, P.O. Box 30016, Brooklyn, New York, 11203.
Nothing can separate, even if I ran away, 'cause your love never fails.
From Jamaica to you with love and with great taste, it's Tasty Patty Bakery and Grill for the most delicious food you've ever tasted. Try the curry goat. So mouth-watering, you must have more than one. Also the curry chicken, jerk chicken, stew cow foot. Try the escovitch fish, brown stew fish, and many other taste-good dishes. All served with rice and peas or white rice. And check out also the soup of the day. You want a patty? Try the Angus beef, Allen chicken, salmon fish, and veggie patties. You love all of them. Tasty Patty Bakery and Grill also has cakes, birthday cakes, fruit cakes, red velvet cakes, and photo cakes with your picture right on the cake. Sample their hard-o bread, Trini Mongoose bread, sweet bread, and other delectable breads and rolls. Tasty also has Nick's Barbados bread, such as tennis rolls, lead pipe, and other favorites. And don't forget the Jackass corn. Remember that? Yes, they have it. Jackass corn at Tasty Patty Bakery and Grill. It's many islands, one people, one love. At Tasty Patty Bakery and Grill, the home of good taste, located at 3122 Church Avenue, 1431 Rockaway Parkway, and 1371 Fulton Street, all in Brooklyn.
Choice Radio, here we go, here we go. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Want inspiration? Want to be lifted and refreshed? You got to turn your radio. Music brings healing, brings joy and life to the deepest. Oh, gotta keep on listening.
As we get ready for the next segment at 1 o'clock, which country bada? If you're a first time listener to Choice Radio, every time at 1 o'clock we open the phone line and try to find out who is representing on the outside. So wherever you're from, get the phone number down, 213-493. Bless you. Oh, I'll give you the wrong number. 347-663-8638. That's the number for 1 o'clock. At that time you'll call the phone as much as you can to shout out your country. Remember, no slogans. If you're from Jamaica, say Jamaica, don't say JA. If you're from Grenada, don't say Spice Isle, say Grenada. And so on and so forth. So at 1 o'clock, we're gonna open the phone lines. Call as much as you can, all right? Don't care what country you're from, be proud of where you're from. All right, that's at 1 o'clock. 347-663-8638. And let me thank all those who call and made a contribution, okay? We definitely thank you guys out there in Radio Land. And like I said, our intention is to make us stronger in the faith. Hallelujah. Glory to the name of Jesus. Yes, he's worthy.
How can I say thanks? Everything you've done, and how can I give praise? Lord, you've given me so much. You get it all, you paid the price. Now I want to give you my life as a sacrifice of praise. Oh, I lift it up to you. Lord, I give my heart away. Give it all to you. Lord, make my life an offering. Let me worship you in everything I do. Sacrifice of praise I give to you. In sunshine and in rain,
sunshine and rain,
in sorrow and in pain,
I will give you praise.
Lord, I will give you praise.
Oh.
And choose to bless your name.
I will bless your name.
You gave it all and you paid the price. Now I want to give you my life as a sacrifice of praise. Lord, I lift it up to you. Lord, I
this troubled world.
This troubled world, yeah.
Is not my final home.
Get ready for 1 o'clock, Witch Country Bada.
Just alone.
Who have the best phone in America? We're gonna find out this afternoon. Who got the fastest fingers?
World.
People from which country have the most patience?
Yeah.
We're gonna find out at 1 o'clock
final
how much patience you have.
Home.
Because the phone will be very, very engaged at 1 o'clock. Which country, Bada?
This troubled world.
This troubled world, yeah.
As we have some fun in the presence of the Lord.
Final home.
Let him in your life today. Give him all.
I don't want
to see all his manifestation. What a mighty God we serve, man.
Oh, no, this world.
Hallelujah, Jesus.
So
yes, Father.
So much confused.
So full of trouble. Oh, hallelujah. People are living in so much fear and misery. Oh, everywhere you turn, my friend, so filled with wrongs. Hallelujah. Christ coming is at hand. Yeah,
this troubled world,
this troubled world, this troubled world,
is not my final home.
No, 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 I don't want to get adjusted.
To get adjusted.
Oh, thank you, Jesus. To this world.
Oh man, the time is moving so fast in the studio. Get ready for 1 o'clock. Which country, Bada? Who have the most patience on the phone lines? 347-663-8638. I cannot find my people from last week to tell you who won last week, but every week it never stayed the same way, man. Be proud of where you're from at 1 o'clock. 347-663-8638. Once you get on the phone, just shout your country name. Jamaica, Grenada, St. Lucia, St. Vincent, Dominica, Barbados, Panama, Haiti, Africa, wherever you're from, all right? Dominica, Antigua, Boy, Lucia.
Ini un jour ka vini, le nou ke dou pou dou va bon Dieu. Tout ça qui j'a sauvé, il n'y a un mot pour déclarer. Une des autres qui bénit, en oui, un papa moi. Manquer des aboutis, en camène les autres finis. Les moins te fait, ou bah moins manger. Les moins te souhaite, messieurs, ou bah moins boire. Ou moins moins étranger, ou ouvert caillou bah moins. Ouvrez-moi tout tout ni aïe, ou mettez à la sous moi, l'aime des malades. Ou béni, ouvrez-moi, moi t'es à prison, messieurs. Ou béni, ôtez-moi, mon coup m'a demandé. Quitte-moi jamais fait ça, Jésus l'a qu'à garder. Évêque qui commence à répondre, tout ça ouvert pour moi, c'est ça ouvert, moi. Les ouvriers vous c'est moi.
en la terre, en oui. Les plus importants pour mon heart qui bandit. Dis nous ni pour weapon pour tout ça nous café. Les nous debout devant jugement Jésus Christ. Les moins de faim pour pas moins manger. Les moins de souhait, méfiant ou pas moins boire. Pour vrai moins étranger ou pouvoir caillou pas moins. Ou vraiment moins tout tout ni aïe. Ou mettez l'inja sous moi. Les moins des malades. Ou venez joindre moi. Moi t'es à prison monsieur. Ou venez aussi moi. Moun commence à demander. Itan, moi jamais fait ça. Jésus la cagade. Avec qui commence à weapon. Tout ça ou fait pour moi.
C'est ça mon
père. Les ou fait pour cesser moi. Ça ouvert pour mon amour. Let ou ba yo manger.
Oh man, get your phones ready.
Let
in 5 more minutes, which country can get the most phone calls inside? Who have the best phone in America? The fastest line? Who have the most patience in the world? We're gonna find out. We gotta give thanks for life. Once we got life, we got hope. We can fix our lives. We can fix it. God is faithful and just. The man who calls for repentance, God honors him. The man who's humble himself. Glory to the name of Jesus, Father. You are worthy. Hey. This Antoine, this one for you. Get your phone ready for 1 o'clock.
I'm feeling the river flowing. Out of my head I'm walking. I'm feeling it. Come say it one more time with me. I'm feeling the river flowing. Out of my head I'm walking. I'm feeling it. Oh Jesus Christ, you got it. I'm feeling the river flowing. Out of my head I'm walking. I'm feeling it. Oh, yeah. Situations had me down in
get ready for the top of the hour. 1 o'clock, call until your finger hurt. 347-663-8638.
I stumble and fall.
He never failed me.
Yeah. I did what I did.
This God we're talking about, man. You guys have no clue.
Jesus.
Trust me. Any man who's been in Christ for a long time and has not been walking upright, you waste a lot of time. You waste a lot of life. You waste a lot of time, baby. This God is real. For those who take him real. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Jesus. The story must be told. Hey.
I stumble and fall.
He never failed me.
Oh, yeah. I did what I did.
He never failed me.
Yes.
Jesus.
He never failed me.
I stumble and fall.
He never failed me.
Man, the phone already gone.
I did what I did.
Give me 1 more minute on my clock.
Hey.
Have a clock from Grenada. 1 minute behind. Wait for my time, people. Okay, they've already gone.
He never failed me. Hey, Jesus.
He never failed me.
I stumbled and
fall. He never failed me.
I did what I did.
He never failed me.
Jesus.
ready now. Which country can get the most phone calls inside? Tell me, caller, where you from? Where you from, caller? Where you from? Where you from? Where you from? Tell me, caller, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Guyana.
Tell me, caller, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Guyana.
Tell me, caller, where you from? Where you from? Where you from? Where you from, caller?
Haiti.
My goodness. Tell me, caller, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
From Panama.
Tell me, caller, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Guyana. Guyana.
My goodness. 347-638-638. I'm talking fast now. Tell me, caller, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Panama.
Tell me, caller, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Grenada.
Tell me, caller, where you from? Where you from? Where you from? Where you from, caller?
Trinidad.
Tell me, caller, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Guyana.
My goodness. 347-663-8638. Which country, bada? Tell me, caller, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Jamaica.
Tell me, caller, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Grenada.
Tell me, caller, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Panama.
Ooh. Tell me, caller, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Grenada.
My God. Tell me, caller, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Guyana.
I said it's gonna be something else today. I know I could feel it. Who gonna do it all the way? That is a big question. Some people start fast and fall away. Hey, tell me, caller, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Panama.
Tell me, caller, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Grenada.
Ooh. 347-663-8638. Write it down. 347-663-8638. Tell me, caller, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Grenada.
Tell me, caller, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Jamaica.
Tell me, caller, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Guyana. Guyana.
347-663-8638. Call till your finger hurt you this morning. 347-663-8638. Call again. If it's busy, do it again. Patience is a virtue, man. That's what they say. Tell me, caller, where you from? Where you from? Where you from? Where you from, caller?
Grenada, Grenada.
Tell me, caller, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Grenada.
Tell me, caller, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Trinidad and Tobago.
Ooh, 347-663-8638. Don't care where you're from. You can make a difference. One person alone can win. Yeah, man. 347-663-8638. Tell me, caller, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
From Panama.
347-663-8638. Keep the fingers moving. Which country, brother? Who can get the most phone calls in? With all the busy tone and everything else. Tell me, caller, where you from? Where you from? Where you from? Where you from, caller?
Grenada.
Tell me, caller, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Saint Lucia.
Ooh, yeah. 347-663-8638. Call it again. You can do it. Tell me, caller, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Guyana.
347-663-8638. Tell me, caller, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Jamaica.
Tell me, caller, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Grenada.
347-663-8638. Write it down. Tell me, caller, where you from? Where you from? Where you from, caller? Where you from?
Panama.
347-663-8638. Which country, brother? Who have the fastest fingers? Who have the most patience? Tell me, caller, where you from? Where you from? Where you from, caller? Where you from?
Jamaica.
347-663-8638. Tell me, caller, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Grenada.
Tell me, caller, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
From Panama.
11 more minutes to go. 11 more minutes. 347-663-8638. Tell me, caller, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Panama.
Who's gonna go all the way today? That's what we're gonna find out. It ain't over till it's over. Don't give up yet. 347-663-8638. Tell me, caller, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Saint Lucia.
My goodness. 347-663-8638. Everybody can make a difference, indeed. Every call is important. 347-663-8638. Tell me, caller, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Jamaica.
347-663-8638. Which country, brother? Tell me, caller, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Grenada.
Tell me, Colour, where you from? Where you from? Where you from? Where you from, Colour?
Grenada.
347-663-8638. Which country, brother? Who can get the most phone calls inside? Tell me, Colour, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
St. Lucia.
Tell me, Colour, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Grenada.
Tell me, Colour, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Trinidad.
How you mean? How you mean? 347-663-8638. Don't give up. 10 more minutes to go. 347-663-8638. Let your fingers do the walking. Huh. Tell me, Colour, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Grenada.
Tell me, Colour, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Grenada.
Tell me, Colour, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Trinidad.
Ooh. 347-663-8638. Do it again. And again, who have the most patience in America? Which country, brother? Who have the best phone system? Hey, tell me, Colour, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Guyana!
Tell me, Colour, where you from? Where you from? Where you from? Where you from, Colour?
St. Vincent and the Grenadines.
What do you mean? 347-663-8638. Don't give up on your country, I tell you, until it's end. 9 more minutes to go. 347-663-8638. Fox, my good morning to you. Which country, brother? Tell me, Colour, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Grenada.
Tell me, Colour, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
St. Lucia.
347-663-8638. Tell me, Colour, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Panama.
How you mean? How you mean? Anybody could do it this morning. Any country can make it. Tell me, Colour, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Guyana.